Assalamualaikum student, today's topic is unit number 5. The title of unit number 5 is The Great Masjid of Cordoba and Iqbal. We will continue book exercise from page number 53 to page number 54. Class 10th, subject English. Now coming to exercise G. State whether the verbs in the following sentences are transitive or intransitive. Name the objects of each transitive verb and the complement of each verb of complete prediction. Before solving this exercise, we will go to the definition of transitive verb. The transitive verb that takes an object is called a transitive verb. For example, Bilal reads the book. In this sentence, subject is Bilal and reads the book. Reads is object, the book is, reads is verb, the book is object. So a verb that takes an object is called a transitive verb. So a verb that takes an object, so it has an object, so it is a transitive verb. Now coming to intransitive verb. A verb that does not take an object is called an intransitive verb. Example, fish swims. Sentence is, in this sentence, fish is subject and swims it is predicate. So intransitive verb, it is without object. The first one is the sun rises in the east. The sun rises in the east. The verb is rises. So we have to figure out whether the verb is transitive or intransitive. So rises is transitive or intransitive? It is intransitive. The sun rises in the east. If a sentence is not, if a verb is not going to answer us the questions what or whom, it is considered as intransitive verb. I repeat, if the verb is not going to answer us the questions what or whom, it is considered as intransitive verbs. So it is not going to answer us the sun rises what or whom. So it is intransitive verb. The dog barks. It has no object, so it is intransitive verb. He raised his hands. He raised his hands. Raised is verb. So he raised his what? It is going to answer us what or whom. A sentence which answer us what or whom, it is termed as transitive verb. So he raised what? He raised his hands. So it is transitive verb. The information proved false. It is intransitive verb because the action is not passing through the object. So it is intransitive verb. The child has fallen asleep. A child has fallen asleep. So it is also intransitive verb because it is not going through, passing through the object. So only sentence number 3 is transitive and rest of all are intransitive verbs. Now coming to exercise H, choose the correct participle, present or past, from the parenthesis. So what is present and past participles? So present participle is first form plus ing. It is termed as present participle, and past participle when we add ed with the base form. So coming to exercise, I am so dash that I don't want to move. I am so relaxed. We will put past participle over here. I am so relaxed. So relaxed is the correct option. I find horror films really dash and no at all fun to watch. And not at all fun to watch. I find horror films really frightening. We will use present participle over here. I find horror films really frightening. Number 3, sometimes I get really dash when I can't express myself well in English. Sometimes I get really frustrated. We will put past participle over here. We were spotted by a man with a knife who took our money. It was dash. It was frightening. The program was really dash. The program was really interesting. So we will put present participle over here. Now coming to clauses. What are clause? What are clauses? What is main clause and what is subordinate clause? Main clauses. Every main clause will follow this pattern. So every main clause must have subject, verb and complete thought. So main clause comprises of subject, verb and which gives a complete thought. For example, lazy students always complain. So students is subject and complains is verb. There are a rest of other example as well. The important point to remember is that every sentence must have at least one main clause. So what is main clause? When main clause has its subject plus verb and it gives complete thought. So it is termed as main clause. And what is subordinate clauses? A subordinate clause will follow this pattern. Subordinate conjunction plus subject plus verb is equal to incomplete thought. So this is the pattern of subordinate clause. Example, whenever lazy students complain. Whenever is subordinate conjunction, students is subject, complain is verb. So whenever in this sentence, whenever is subordinate conjunction, as is subordinate conjunction, because is subordinate conjunction. I will repeat it for one more time. Subordinate clauses. A subordinate clause will follow this pattern. Subordinate conjunction plus subject plus verb is equal to incomplete thought. Now coming to exercise. Underline the main clause and encircle the subordinate clause or clause in the following sentence. So what is main clause, which has its subject and verb and complete thought, and what is subordinate clause, which start with subordinate conjunction, then subject, then verb and incomplete thought. Okay, we have to underline the main clause and we have to encircle the subordinate clause. So Jameel spoke as though he were a born orator. Jameel spoke. Jameel spoke, it is main clause. Jameel is subject, spoke is verb. It give complete thought. So it is main clause. As though he were a born orator. As is subordinate conjunction. As is subordinate conjunction. As though he were a born orator. It gives an incomplete thought. So it is termed as subordinate clause. Second, When at last he returned to the village, the people told him that his mother had died. The people told him that his mother had died. It gave us complete thought. So it is main clause. When at last he returned to the village, when is subordinate conjunction. So the encircled one is subordinate clause. The newspaper will tell us tomorrow what the world does today. The newspaper will tell us tomorrow. This part of sentence is main clause. What the world does today, what is subordinate conjunction. What the world does today, this is subordinate clause. Number four, the few books that were produced in the Middle Ages were written by hand. The few books were written by hands. The few books were written by hands. This and this part, we will join together it and it will make main clause. The few books were written by hand. It is termed as main clause. That were produced in the Middle Ages. That is subordinate conjunction. That were produced in the Middle Ages. So this is subordinate clause. When the world was young, artists drew their pictures on stone. When the world was young, when is subordinate conjunction? So when the world was young, it is subordinate clause. Artist drew their pictures on stone. It is main clause. So all the phrases which are underlined, these are main clause, and all the phrases which are encircled or in brackets, these are subordinate clauses. Now coming to exercise J, choose the correct tense for each sentence. After Javeria dash her degree, she intends to work in an office. After Javeria finished her degree, so C option is the correct one. Leila looked down to discover a snake. When she saw it, she dash. When she saw it, she screamed. Second form of word, so we will use past tense. I borrowed 4 books on gardening the last time I dashed to the library. I went to the library. By the time I go to bed tonight, I dash my work for the day. I will have finished my work for the day. Until you learn how to take a break, you dash your ability to speak English. You won't improve your ability to speak English. Now coming to past perfect continuous tense. What is past perfect continuous tense? What is the structure of it? First of all, we will revise it and then we will solve its exercise. The past perfect continuous tense is used to talk about the continuation of an action in the distant past before another action. We use the auxiliary had been plus present participle with I, you, we, they, he, she, it, and all singular and plural nouns. Affirmative sentence is, I had been painting the wall since morning. Negative of it is, I had not been painting the wall since morning. Interrogative of it, had I been painting the wall since morning. Now coming to exercise K, make the past perfect continuous tense. So we will make past perfect continuous tense of it. You have to write down it on your book. I had been working. So there are the words which are in brackets. It gives us hint to use these verbs. So we have to use the verbs accordingly. The past perfect continuous tense. I had been working. So we use first form with ing in past perfect continuous tense. So I had been working all day, so I didn't want to go out. She had been sleeping for 10 hours when I woke her. They had been living in Beijing for 3 years when he lost his job. When we met, you had been working at that company for 6 months. We had been eating all day, so we felt a bit ill. So in the blank spaces you have to write had been working, had been sleeping, had been living, had been working, had been eating. Now coming to activity, you have to revise all the grammar which are in these exercises. Thank you.